In the third and final part of Planet Shooter Edit, I get to work through three of the images from the Vintage Explorer photoshoot. Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and you're watching Adorama TV, brought to you by Adorama, the camera store that's got everything for us photographers. Well, the Vintage Explorer theme shoot is done, and in this video, I'm going to edit some of the pictures I took on the shoot. Now, in the first video of this little series of three, you watched me do all the planning and organizing stage. In the previous video, I did all of the shooting stage, and this will be the edit. But it's an edit with a bit of a difference, because although I've sorted the pictures out, I've not edited any of them yet. So you'll get to watch as I edit live. That should be fun. Now, I did three shoots. How did they go? I had a shoot that I really didn't need to do, so an unnecessary shoot. I had the planned shoot and then the unexpected shoot. So this is the image I want to edit, and it's the unnecessary shoot because I didn't really need to do it. This was sort of like my banker shoot to make sure I've got something in the studio before we headed out on location. I think the first thing to do is probably a bit of housekeeping whilst I think about what I'm going to do with it. So let's pop the noise reduction up a little bit, and we'll maybe tweak the colours a little bit to the warmer side and the exposure a tiny little bit too. Okay, so first thing to do, well, I wanted to sort of vintage feel with this, so maybe we should just tweak the colours and bring the vibrance down a little bit, not that much, a little bit. I'm more or less happy with that, maybe a little bit of tweak on the contrast, a little bit less in the clarity. It looks a little bit muddy down by her feet, so to brighten that area up, I'm going to get the adjustment brush. Let's pop up the exposure a little bit and add some clarity. Okay, here we go. Let's make the brush a bit bigger. And the reason it's a little bit dark down here is because I was using a relatively small softbox. But let's open that image up, because to get this real vintage feel in the studio shots, I've done this before, I like to get a vintage feel by using a piece of software that's not Photoshop, it's Nik software. I've used Nik software for absolutely years. I just go to Filter, then down to Nik Collection and Analog Effects Pro 2. Now, the reason I like Nik software is it gives you a bunch of previews of what you might want to do, sort of stepping stones, ideas that you can jump off of. And it's great for that, because I can just click on these, and whilst it's not instant, because it does show the age of the software, it's relatively quick just to change things around and you get a feel. Actually, I quite liked that one. That's interesting. I wasn't expecting to like that one, because it's a bit on the green side. So I don't need the dirt and scratches, that can go. Let's come down to the film type, take away any noise, that can come back. And the way to use this is not the strength at 100, but the strength at 0. And then the film effect, the color grading, I bring up slowly to give me the look, otherwise it can become very overpowering. And I reckon that's probably about right. I might need to bring the opacity down and maybe just tweak the levels a little bit, but well, there you go. There is the first shot from the unnecessary shoot done. So the next shot is from the main location, the one I actually went and location scouted in the Planet video. 2 days later, when we were there for the shoot, it was full of kids learning to climb rocks. So I didn't have much access to the area. I was really limited in space and the good stuff I couldn't get to. So let's have a look at the picture. Well, let's do the housekeeping. Let's do the noise reduction before I forget. White balance, that's realistic. It was cold. Let's bring it up to a much less realistic color, but much more warm tone, because that's what it should have been. It was cold up there. I mean, it was genuinely cold. And Kerry did have my hot water bottle, which was nice, but everybody on location, I made sure had a packet of these before we left, so they were warmed up, little hand warmers, really useful just to stick in your pockets and stop your hands getting really cold. Everybody except me, I left mine behind, typical. This bit looks a bit bright. Let's just see if I can deal with that. I'll get the graduated filter, knock the exposure back a little bit. Yeah, there we go, maybe a bit of clarity in there. That looks better, and I think I'm going to stop there. Done. We did get lucky with the weather, and if you saw the first video of this series, you know I had to change the date because of the weather forecast. I'm actually recording this video the day we were going to go outside. Let me take you outside, because I can see behind you is my cabin door, and this is what it looks like outside looking back at the cabin. I'm really glad we're not shooting today. However, it wasn't really until we started to head home that the skies cleared and I could see there was going to be a great sunset, and I knew on the way home we could stop at a local lake and take some pictures. it worked out so well. It was just freezing cold, so we didn't have much time. This is one of the shots that I want to edit, and the first thing I want to do here is probably just sort out the, for some reason, the wonky horizon. Don't know why that happened. Normally I would increase the magentas on my sunset shots, but that's not really this shot's. I'm going to increase the temperature, that's better. And let's pop some saturation. Whee, not that much saturation. That's a little bit strong. Go for vibrant. I should go for vibrance first because it's a more targeted way of adjusting the saturation. We'll pop up the highlights a little bit. We can tweak the shadows and the contrast. There's really not much more to do. Obvious housekeeping stuff like noise reduction. That would be a good thing. Yeah, I'm going to open that up. There we go. So there's an obvious thing that you've probably spotted, which was the huge Zeppelin in the corner. I need to remove that with a little bit of cloning. So cloning, how am I going to do this? Well, there's lots of cloning tools. Let's try the automated stuff first. Let's try the patch tool. You never know your luck. If the automated tools will work, then use them. That's my theory. And surprisingly, that's quite close. I reckon we've got to do a little bit of tidying up, but I don't think there's much to do there. I think that's fine. There's a few other areas I need to sort out. So I've got the modern signage in here. So using the healing brush, not the patch tool, the healing brush, let's just go and heal that area. That looks pretty good. Okay, and there we go. And then the line here, that little sticky up bit is a power cable, which of course is not really in keeping. Little floaty thing, that could be there. I can live with that. Another power cable. There's a bunch of little buoys here, which probably should be removed as well. So there you go. That is the last shot edited. One thing that I could have improved the shoot by is with the umbrella, the parasol that was missing. I mentioned it way back in the first video. I ordered a second one and it arrived the day of the shoot. Whilst I was actually on the shoot, I got an email saying, we've left it with a neighbour. This is it. This is the thing I think I could have used to improve it. It's not come out the bag, so, oh, it does open. I thought it was broken for a minute. And there you go. That would have, I think, just given us the extra edge for this shoot, but what can you do? So if you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave me a comment below. And if you want to see more videos from myself and the other amazing presenters right here on Adorama TV, you know what you got to do? You got to click on the subscribe button. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.